Well, the background of the CART study is that we have a number of agents in the management of metastatic castrate-resistant prostate cancer. Two taxanes, docetaxel and cabazitaxel, and several androgen receptor targeted agents, including abiraterone and enzalutamide. And these drugs have been developed more or less in parallel. So one of the remaining questions is, what should you use first, which one second, and which one third? And we know that there is cross-resistance between enzalutamide and abiraterone because they target the same receptor, the androgen receptor. And we know that patients who are failing on enzalutamide may not respond to abiraterone and vice versa. We know that chemotherapy, cabazitaxel, a second-line chemotherapy, retains its activity after docetaxel, as well as after abiraterone and enzalutamide. So the CART study was a randomized open-label study to compare the efficacy and safety of cabazitaxel versus abiraterone or enzalutamide in patients who had been on one series of docetaxel and one line of AR-targeted treatment. That could have been abiraterone or enzalutamide. And in the CART study, patients were randomized to receive cabazitaxel or the alternative AR-targeted agents. So patients who had been on ENSA were randomized to receive cabazitaxel or abiraterone, and patients who had been on abiraterone were randomized to receive cabazitaxel or enzalutamide. The study was designed as a superiority trial to test superior radiographic progression-free survival for cabazitaxel. 255 patients were enrolled, and that allowed us to reach 196 radiographic progression events that were needed to test a hazard ratio of 0.67. That was the primary aim. A key secondary endpoint was overall survival, and then there were a number of other secondary endpoints. The key endpoint, radiographic progression-free survival, was statistically significantly superior for cabazitaxel. Median RPFS was 8 months on cabazitaxel, and it was 3.7 months on abi or enza. So RPFS was more than doubled. And the hazard ratio was 0.54, so it was robustly significant. Also, the secondary endpoint, overall survival, was strikingly positive, with an overall survival on cabazitaxel 13.6 months, whereas it was 11 months on abi or enza. So difference of 2.6 months, hazard ratio 0.64, implicating a 36% reduction in risk of death. Well, I think the data are robust, clinically meaningful, statistical significant, clinically meaningful, and I think that we should stop crossing over between abiraterone and enzalutamide. We should not lose the window of opportunity of giving the right drug at the right time. And cabazitaxel in this trial was obviously the winner. Cabazitaxel in this study was well tolerated. It was the European dose, 25 milligrams per square meter, plus primary G-CSF prophylaxis. And the incidence of neutropenic fever at any cycle during treatment was only 3.2%. And if you look at any adverse events grade 3 or above, serious adverse events, the rates were identical between the two study arms.